If you asked what I'm passionate about, I would say stewardship. I would say that we, that people, have a critical responsibility for preserving and protecting our natural resources. Not just for the protection of the environment, for the plants and animals that live there, but also for the ecosystem services that ecosystems support, used to support humans. So if you think about the Arctic and you think about changes that are occurring there, you can think about the glaciers melting, which is happening in alpine regions as well. But the consequences not only include rising sea levels and flooding of coastal cities, which impacts millions and billions of people, but also the changes to the ocean chemistry and changes to ocean conditions have consequences for the organisms that live there, that have consequences for human nutrition. So our responsibility for the ecosystem extends far beyond our own backyards. And that's why I feel I'm uniquely suited to make that, teach that lesson to my students. I teach 6th, 7th, and 8th grades, so I have the opportunity to reinforce conservation messages with my students. We take our 6th graders to environmental camp, we take our 7th graders for service learning in Cuyahoga Valley National Park, we take all of them, I take all of my kids outside for lessons in soils, in water quality testing, in how water moves through the watershed, in biodiversity. I'm fortunate to have space on our school campus and in an adjoining park, so I can do a lot of environmental education with my kids and get them outside understanding and appreciating the natural world. My Polar Trek experience did not bring me to outdoor education. I was already doing that, but it has very much enriched my classroom lesson planning. Polar Trek. Trek stands for teachers and researchers exploring and collaborating. So the idea is to get teachers into the field and then have them share what researchers are discovering in polar regions. So that experience enriched my classroom lessons because I am better now at incorporating the skills that students need to learn to be good researchers, to be critical thinkers, and you do that in the out of doors, using environmental education as a framework to teach them basic skills, as well as to learn the lessons of conservation. Really, as an educator, learning the skills has been the most important focus of what I do. Kids need to learn the concepts and the ideas. We can all look those things up on the internet. The internet's a great tool, but we can only do that if we're good critical thinkers. So I teach my kids to be problem solvers, to find data and analyze data, to be critical thinkers, to understand or make claims and the evidence that supports those claims. Too many people are afraid of science. They have a mistrust of science because they don't understand well enough how to think critically and how to evaluate evidence. And so as an educator, that's really an important focus of what I do. And again, having the conservation experience that I've had in distant parts of the world, especially in Greenland, has enriched me as a teacher, but also given me tools and a message to share with the public, which includes the Audubon Society. And I look forward to talking to the Audubon Society, meeting the Audubon Society's guests on March 3rd, 2020.